Have you found yourself stuck at home, worrying about how the world is handling the devastating situation our society is currently living in, the ramifications and consequences that our current measures might leave for the future, and on top of that, the invisible threat that is lurking everywhere and you are unable to avoid it, endangering your life and that of your loved ones? Great! So is everyone else who clicked on this video. And what you also probably have in common is that you are trying to get your mind off that pesky reality and play some damn games. I'm Bobby, and this is Evo, and this is Top 10 Games for Quarantine.
Let's start off with the darling that came out during this whole mess. Animal Crossing has been a blessing that released at just the right time to help ease the minds of people stuck at home. With the possibility of sinking hundreds of hours into, combined with its relaxing atmosphere, makes it probably the perfect game for quarantine. This just might be the one time people don't mind being in an endless debt.
Doom Eternal is like Animal Crossing's biological twin. Only not identical, and definitely not as heavenly. Being released on the same day as its sibling, Doom might not be nearly as long, but it's definitely twice the fun. Nothing else like blasting and disassembling demons in every way possible. It serves like a really good release of stress, which by this point I'm sure we all have buckets of. And when you're done with its very fun campaign, you can always jump into multiplayer for some more mortally challenged good times.
If you're either not a Nintendo fan or already got tired of life and a few responsibilities in Animal Crossing, you should consider playing Stardew Valley. It is inspired by games like Animal Crossing and Harvest Moon, but honestly, I prefer this game way more. It allows you to live on a farm and grow crops and keep livestock, but don't forget about all the relationship drama though. Great to get some social interaction while staying at home.
Honestly, there are tons of RPGs we can put on here. All of them can be great time sinks. However, of all of them, I think Fire Emblem is one of the best we can offer. This game can take over 100 hours to finish for one playthrough only. And there are four endings! Add all of the customization options it gives you, the amount of replayability adds up to insane. If you have ever wanted to check this game out, or even if you haven't, now might be a pretty good time.
If you prefer a more traditional JRPG, one of the best games you could pick up would be the latest Dragon Quest. This one would easily take you about 100 hours to finish the story, and still gives you extra quests and stories to explore as well. If you are a fan of the old Dragon Quest games in 2D, it's also worth noting you could play the whole game in a 2D pixel art style as well. For me, this was the game that has kept me hooked during the past few months.
Anyone having an existential crisis yet? No? Then to speed up the process, I suggest playing through Nier Automata. This game is bonkers. It's rare for me to play a game where it leaves me so at peace when I finish it. Sure, I say crying under the table kind of peace, but I say what other kind is there? Besides the bucket of tears, you can also expect from this game a multi-layered gaming experience, where it constantly switches between gameplay styles that blend even better than the story, which combines high-stake action war over Earth with philosophy about one's existence and its meaning. This shit is deep, I'm telling you. And similar to Fire Emblem, it has multiple endings. You can keep coming back to this one in between each tier fest. It is one of the games that I feel I can without hesitation call a masterpiece from recent years. And it's one that I think, if you have the time, which I know you do, you might consider giving it a shot.
Sometimes you just get tired of those hand-holdy stories. A good solution for this is to play a completely free sandbox game, like Minecraft. I assume everyone knows what Minecraft is about. You either play in a creative mode to just build, or in a survival mode, where you need to survive and collect the resources to build. Another thing worth noting is that Minecraft is one of the most fun multiplayer games to play with your friends. You could invite them to your own world, or play whatever kind of minigame together.
And then you have Tetris. I think that is all the intro this one needs. Although not just any Tetris, but the one that made everyone who hadn't bought the Nintendo Switch online do so. Tetris 99 is a prime example of a time waster. And I mean that in the best way possible. Between the different modes, milestones, and such, this is a game that you can just jump into whenever you feel like it. Invest some time, and then come back whenever you beat everything else from this list. I guess you can replace this with any other Tetris, but that feeling, when you get that first spot, is a very special geek moment that now might be the perfect time for you to strive and achieve.
The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt is another must-play. This RPG is solid in many areas, especially when it comes to story and characters. The world is one to truly get lost in, and it's a game that's easy to learn yet can be challenging to master. This game comes packed to the brim with many quests and stories, and then also has two extra DLC packs that just add so much extra content. This game will teach you about all kinds of different beasts and myths, while providing a complex story filled with tragic characters and their relations.
So from all the games on this list that we have talked about, this is the only one I haven't finished. Well, and Tetris, but story-wise. And even with that, I can already say this is going to be a golden recommendation for me by the time I'm done. Besides being long, this game has so many design layers that just pile on top of one another, and not one of them feels out of place. That is saying much when you have a game with a talking cat. I'm reluctant to call this a masterpiece in the likes of Nier yet, but I feel like that call card might be inevitable. If you're like me and want to play an RPG with some great characters, fighting to save the world from people who think themselves way above others, I suggest you give this one a shot. Especially with Royal out now, there's little excuse not to give this one a try.
Long story short, just play any game that allows you to sink a shit ton of hours into.